Hi guys, Luton here. So over the past few years I've been lucky to work with some really awesome producers, and like many YouTube channels you see down the side, the featured list of channels, and this is channels that you can place there that you think are particularly worthwhile, or that you work with, or that you want your subscribers to take a look at. But just having those there doesn't necessarily mean that people are going to bother to click through, or that they don't actually subscribe or whatever. So I thought today I would actually take some time to go through the list of people that I have on my featured list and explain to you why they're there and why I think they're worth your while to take a look at. So first of all, Acoustic Labs. Now, Greg on Acoustic Labs I've been working with for several years now. And both when mine and his channel were quite small, I was looking around for background music for my videos, and he was very, you know, generously enough to, you know, and he was very generous enough to actually allow me to use his music for my background music on my videos. And this really gave a lot of character and strength to my early videos. It really made a bit of a difference between them, and it really suited the style in which I approached them. And, you know, it's fair to say that without his channel and without his music and his skill, perhaps, you know, early on, my channel wouldn't have grown in a way that it did. So that was a really, really positive thing. It was fantastic to have that support, and it continues to be. I use his music regularly still, and I use it for things like Arma 3 videos and so on, where it really, the two things really go strongly together. He covers a range of music. He does covers of tracks in his acoustic style. He also produces unique pieces that he makes himself and composes himself. And, you know, the level of skill that Greg has with his productions are just absolutely awe-inspiring. I can't recommend enough for you to go and check it out. He also has multiple albums that you can buy from iTunes, which feature a lot of the music that I use on my channel. So I'd suggest if you enjoy that stuff, go and check that out as well. Next up, of course, Level Cap. Now, Level Cap, or Charlie, me and him, we started kind of talking way back. It was back when I was still doing stuff for Battlefield O. Some of you guys may remember that, the very early beginnings of my YouTube channel. So it was right from the very beginning that I had spoken with Level Cap, back when his channel was around, I don't know, was it like 80,000, 90, 100,000? It was that kind of size. And basically he was asking around for somebody to produce a little thumbnail for his Get to the Chopper series. Because basically, yeah, he needed someone to put that together. I said, oh yeah, I'll do that for you. You know, we didn't know each other or anything like that. I was just like, yeah, I wanted, you know, something I could do, so I put it together. And since then, of course, we got chatting a little bit. We went on to make our On the Level series. He, you know, appeared in many of the podcasts that I put back together then for Battlefield Roundtable. And now we started to do this kind of armor stuff as well. But, you know, Level Cap's channel, he works so hard on that channel to put out such a range and quality of content. And he really covers so many of the elements that you really need to know without a lot of the crap there. He's not scared to put forward his own opinions, as you will have recently seen with the Hardline stuff, which is a really important and positive feature of the channel, to be able to say exactly what you think and to be not obviously someone who's just kind of kowtowing to the powers that be, or just kissing ass constantly, which I have to say I do see on a lot of channels now, especially channels that are trying to impress or because they want to kind of create roadways for exclusive content. Level Cap, he gets access to the things that he needs to, but it doesn't compromise that by sort of kissing up all the time. You know, he still will always tell you what he thinks. He covers in great detail from many different things, from statistics but right through to kind of speculation and discussion. So from my point of view, he's just one of the best producers out there, and the channel size and growth reflects that. I'm sure that many of you guys watch me are subscribed already, but if you're not, I would strongly recommend that you go and check him out. Okay, so next up will be Chris from Battle Nonsense. Now, his channel is quite kind of, I wouldn't say necessarily new, but it's kind of up and coming within the sort of Battlefield producer scene. And, you know, really it all came about, I guess, from sort of the Battlefield 4 point of view, that he was looking at the elements and the things that needed to be improved and fixed within Battlefield 4. And the channel's kind of grown out of that. But much like myself, Chris, you know, it's good because he criticizes elements that need fixing, and he looks in detail what the issues are there way more than I do. But the thing that we both do is put forward suggestions and solutions about how these things can be actually changed. And you know, that's a really important thing, because again, I've seen other videos and producers and channels where they are all too much to kind of shout out and say, oh, this is doesn't work, this is broken, fix this, they owe us this, blah blah blah, but doesn't actually provide any real solutions. And that's something that Chris on his channel does very well. He provides practical and also importantly realistic solutions, not just kind of like, oh, give us this or give us this. No, he actually comes forward and suggests things that will improve and fix that situation. And these are actually feasible, and that's important because providing feasible solutions means that there's actually a realistic possibility that those could be implemented into the game. And that's the reason why you should go and check out his channel and give him your support, because the more people that watch his stuff and listen to what he talks about, the more knowledge that you have means that you can kind of discuss better on different social media with the developers and, you know, all work together to produce and work for, you know, a better game franchise for everybody. Okay, now next up, a big favourite of mine is Tech Syndicate. Now, Logan and the guys on Tech Syndicate, they really put together a kind of, I wouldn't say it's exclusively, but mainly, you know, they do focus on kind of PC matters, hardware, software, and the general industry. They talk a lot about ISPs, usually in the US, and they also talk about things like net neutrality a lot and so on and so on. But they do talk about things within the EU when it's relevant to do so, and so, you know, they're quite happy to kind of cover whatever is necessary. But the main reason why I really like Tech Syndicate is, one, they have really intellectual discussions. They actually have, you know, constructive discussions about things. But also, you know, they're not worried about the production length. They're quite happy to go to half an hour, 40 minutes, an hour, to sort of talk these things out and really go through it all. And that's one of the main features for me that I really enjoy, is having a show and a series that you can really get your teeth into. It's not just like a 5-minute clickbait job. They really provide excellent quality content that you can listen to, you can think about, and actually learn something from, instead of just like a load of whatever, like I say, clicky, fuzzy, you know, throwaway nonsense. It's stuff that you can actually relate to, that you can think about, and I would say it's you know, it's a fairly sort of adult show. It's a show where you can really sort of engage your brain and think about things, and that's a really positive thing for any YouTube channel. Okay, next up it's the big man himself, Jack Frags. Now, Jack, I first met Jack way back at the release of Battlefield 4, I think it was, when we went to Sweden, and so lucky, so privileged to be able to go to that trip. Got to go to DICE, that was so good. But yes, meeting Jack there. Now, the funny thing was that trip, there was a load of people that I didn't know. Okay, loads of people. For example, Syndicate was there. And Syndicate was there being himself, being all, you know, loud and proud. And I was just like, man, who is this guy? I didn't know who he was. But then also Jack was there, and I didn't know who Jack was as well. You know, I just knew he was another producer, so we were like, hello, hello. Got chatting, had a nice time. You know, I've been to a few things with Jack now, and he's always just been a really pleasant, really professional guy, and very much enjoyed the way in which he works and the way in which he produces his content. And that's really, you know, one of the reasons why I have him there on my bar, is that just his quality of his content is exceptional. The effort that he puts in, he obviously also has a fantastic knowledge of all gaming aspects. You know, his competitive background is a huge support and gives him a very strong point of view. But you know, much like myself, Jack's one of those gamers who just appreciates all games, and you know, the stuff that he puts through his channel, it's really positive to see someone sort of breaking out and posting other things, not just, you know, a consistent sole thing for the channel. I like to see when people are putting some variation out there, because it gives you more depth for that person. You can see what they're all about. But Jack's focused on so many different things, from the Easter egg stuff to the technicalities to the enjoyment of the game. He really goes in many different directions and does so competently and professionally throughout all of them. So, you know, Jack, as I'm sure many of you subscribe already, he's just a very, very excellent producer, and you should absolutely be subscribed. Okay, so going from a massive producer like Jack to an up-and-coming producer, and this is Tony Mo. Now, Tony Mo was a channel that I basically came across just while I was kind of browsing, looking for new channels, which I do very often, and very rarely find anything worthwhile actually subscribing to. But Tony, I saw like a thumbnail for one of his things, and I was like, that sounds interesting, click through. And his content is great. It's one of these channels where it's super frustrating that he does not have more subscribers and more views on his content, because it is all excellent. He has a fantastic point of view, a very good way of discussing topics, and he's again covering many different titles there. So I recommend going checking out Tony's videos. You'll see for yourself, and I'm sure you'll be able to conclude that he's worth subscribing to. I've done one video with him, I intend to do some more, but he's just a very, you know, nice, friendly, competent guy in the way in which he produces, and I think he's worthwhile of your subscription. Okay, now next we come to Culprit. Now Culprit has got two channels, his Battlefield and his gaming channel. So Culprit008 and Culprit Gaming. And he's one of these producers which has been around within the Battlefield sphere for a while. And the content that he puts out, I think, is always fantastic. I think, again, he has a great way of discussing topics and covering the issues. But mainly, I watch Culprit for his gaming stuff. And much like my Looting Gaming channel, his gaming channel is fairly small. But the work that he puts in there and the stuff that he produces is just really, really enjoyable. He does longer videos of Let's Plays, he does stuff like Timber and Stone or Prison Architect and soon to come Rimworld as well. And I just find that stuff really, really enjoyable to watch. He has a very kind of storytelling approach to his videos and I find it just very, very relaxing and enjoyable to get through those. The way in which, again, he interacts with his subscriber base on those videos is fantastic and fun to watch. And you know, those games have the potential to be not that interesting, but through his commentary he really makes them come to life, and that's one of the reasons why I subscribe there. And I would recommend that you go and check it out. He brings that same personality through in his Battlefield videos as well, and his points of view, again, are often very similar to mine in the kind of constructive and, I would say, balanced way he approaches different issues and topics. So go check out both of Culprit's channels. I think they're really worth a look. Okay, next up, a producer who I haven't worked with yet on any videos, but I'm intending to, and potentially it might be a kind of podcast series. That is Lionheart. Now, Lionheart's channel probably couldn't be more different than mine. He works on kind of historical RTS-based stuff, like Total War primarily. But basically, I met Lionheart at the Alien Isolation event that I went to a little while back, and we were having to be sitting next to one another while we were gaming, got chatting, and he's just a really fantastic guy. He's just a really nice guy. His content that he puts forward, that really comes through. And again, just really interesting and fantastic to listen to the things that he talks about and the work that he does. This historical aspect is very appealing to me because I enjoy that kind of content. So again, our channels are kind of at different odds, but somehow I kind of, there's a bit of a crossover there, I guess, in perhaps just the personality aspect, the way in which we kind of relate. So I'm looking forward to working with him on some things. I potentially am going to look at some more sort of historical RTS stuff. It might be on my other channel, it might be on this channel. But yeah, you know, Lionheart, go check it out. It might be something that appeals to you if you have a kind of broader approach to the way that you enjoy things on YouTube, topics on YouTube. Okay, next up is Blue Drake. Now, Blue Drake was someone suggested to me via Twitter the other day, and I made the effort, as I often do, to try and contact him and see whether it gets back to me. Now, a lot of producers, when you do this, are kind of like, they get so much spam anyway, that sometimes when you actually get contacted by other producers, that can get lost in the spam. But luckily with Drake, he actually got back to me, and the main reason is because he's one of these producers like myself, who actually interacts and talks and replies to his followers and people in the community, and that's a really positive thing. So me and Drake got together, we had a bit of a chat, and I said, hey, like, you know, let's talk, let's do some stuff. We ended up playing a load of Battlefield. He's put a video up on his channel of us playing Battlefield. But the best thing about Blue Drake, and the thing that really made me straight away, I watched several of his videos, and you know, our personalities don't align perfectly because he's a little bit more sort of free-for-all in the way that he talks about things than me, but overall was pretty much on the level. You know, he has basically a totally no bullshit approach to gaming. You know, he's not interested in the hype, he's not interested in the egos, he's not interested in the crap. What he's interested in is playing the games and playing them and enjoying them and talking to people about them, and it really comes through. You know, it's just a out and out frank gaming channel, and that's something that I really commend and appreciate these days in a world of ultra clickbait hype fest. It's something that I just saw and immediately I was like, damn it, I love this channel. But hilariously, he admits that he doesn't understand why people watch his content, because he literally just plays games, talks about it and posts it up, and he doesn't get why people like that. But the reason I like it and the reason I think a lot of people like it is because of that. They're so sick of the complete bullshit that's around on YouTube, and he offers a complete solution there. So I go check it out. It might be something that you know, his channel, you might think is surprising that it, like I said, doesn't align with kind of the way that I produce things sometimes. But, you know, sometimes not necessarily opposites attract, but if you have a slight difference of opinion, it can make things all the more interesting. And I think that's the way I'm kind of looking at it. Okay, and now last, but by a long margin, not least, RPG Minx, Manga Minx. Minx, the lady herself, Minx. Minx and me got talking way back, it must have been like a year ago, I guess, maybe. And this was back when her channel was about 30,000 subscribers. And we did a few little videos, podcasts on my secondary channel together. It meant to be more, but then through one thing or another, being busy, etc., it kind of, we didn't get round to that. But now we're back on with it. We're producing this regular podcast series, which you will have seen, MLD, Minx and Lutin Discuss. It's going out kind of bi-weekly on my channel and on her channel as well. Minx's channel could not be further removed from mine. Her channel is just gaming hilarity. It's just often a lot of indie games, just craziness. And you know, I present myself in such a serious way a lot of the time. A lot of people think that that's just how I am. But from when I was at EGX there, and I was talking to like Dolce and Spanjay, and from other bits and pieces, and when people that I play with, and for example, when I was playing like Toybox Turbos the other day, a lot of people are like, wow, Lutin, you're quite different in real life. Yeah, yeah, I'm not like a 100% serious guy all the time. It's just that when I'm talking about the games, some games I approach in a really, really serious way, other games I don't. And that's really the thing. It's like, I enjoy playing serious titles, but I also enjoy having a hell of a lot of fun with other games. And Minx's channel is all about the fun. She just has hilarious time. And the stuff that she comes out with sometimes, it's just, I could never do. She's just an amazing character of a person. And you absolutely need to go and check out her YouTube channel. Like I say, it's absolutely polar from mine, but in many ways, you know, that can be a good thing. I think it's worth sometimes reaching out, being open-minded, and looking at a lot of different things. I love Minx and I love her channel. You need to go and check it out. So that's been my little breakdown of the featured list, guys. In the comments below, please discuss these different producers, talk about what it is that you like about them, and please as well suggest any YouTube channels that you think are worth me looking at, people that I might not be aware of, because I am all the time trying to find worthwhile YouTube producers to subscribe and follow, and I tell you what, they're few and far between these days. So put it all down in the comments below. Thanks for watching today. I hope this has been a helpful video. I'm going to have some stuff coming up about the Steam Winter Sale. I've got a ton of content to produce that I want to make at the moment. It's just time. I never have enough time. If I was working full-time on YouTube, I'd tell you what, I'd be producing 3 videos a day. But being that I'm not, I have to do it as I can. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you on the next one.